Hi there, great to have you back. I thought it might be of interest to point out a nice observation I've done on one of those two-stroke engines I'm currently rebuilding. Normally, two-stroke engines have those openings called ports within the cylinder walls that let the fuel mixture in and the exhaust gas out. Controlled is the whole process by the piston, while it runs up and down the cylinder in the right amount of time and angle. The piston rings on top are traveling within the groove. That is no secret. So the opening of the piston rings would eventually end up within the ports one time, and that could cause problems because the piston ring would slightly open and the edge of the ports would destroy the piston ring, causing an engine failure. Now, to avoid this, normally the pistons have those piston pins to lock the piston rings in the right angle within the groove. Now, when I took the original piston off when taking the engine apart, or at least the one that was installed, I look at the piston and compare it and measure it, what I saw was the absence of those piston pins. So I did some research to figure out what's going on, since the maintenance manuals are not that clear and detailed. So I figured out that these pistons never had those pins on that Velosolex two-stroke engine. So the replacement piston, which you can see here, doesn't have the pins either. So the question that came along to me was that why does that engine run so reliable since decades and not causing any problems with that theoretical problem that is written everywhere? So to verify that I haven't overlooked that pin within the groove, I'm taking off the first piston ring, first compression piston ring. I do that with a piston ring plier to make sure I'm not overstretching it. You see, this is the piston ring tension, and if you overbend it, you could change that tension that could cause troubles earlier or later. Anyway, here you can see the piston groove, and there is definitely no pin within that groove that could lock the piston rings in a certain angle to avoid the piston openings ever to run over the ports. My question here, as I said, is why does that engine run? Why did that engine run? And why does it run so reliable? To demonstrate how it looks when one of those piston ring openings end up over one of the ports, I just quickly lubricate the cylinder walls and install a piston ring within the cylinder. This is also normally the way how you measure the piston ring gap. In order to press it down to the port, I use a piece of plastic. This way it's perfectly aligned all the way within the cylinder while going down. Here you see the piston ring gap over the exhaust port, and this is exactly the problem that could arise. The bigger that porthole is, the more likely the piston ring would open here, and while it runs over the edge of the port, causing problems, and the ring could eventually break. Here you see all three piston rings installed, and that would be the ideal way of installation and the ideal position of the piston ring gaps, how they should be locked. So none of the openings are running over one of the ports. This is more or less like 120 degrees to each other. That's ideal. This is how you install piston rings, for instance, on a four-stroke engine, to make sure they never end up over each other to lose compression right away. So, yeah, I assume that the opening size is crucial in that particular situation. That VeloSelect engine has small port openings, and I assume that is why it still works, why the piston rings won't open. Now, here some additional information. If you ever measure the piston, you must know that the top of the piston is of smaller diameter. So whenever measuring it, you need to measure it perpendicular to the piston pin axis on the lower portion of the piston, like in the last third. Normally we use a micrometer, but just for demonstration I use the caliper. It's clearly visible here that the top, this is actually a nominal piston size of 39.5 at 20 degrees Celsius. So at top we have here 39.27 millimeters, and if we now measure perpendicular to the piston pin axis, you can see the 39.5. Why is it tapered? The top has the most friction where the piston rings are, and that will cause more expansion, and in a normal ideal engine, theoretically, the piston is perfectly cylindrical as soon as the engine reaches normal temperatures. This much for now. I hope you liked it. Thanks for watching. If you have questions or comments, you can drop them in the comments line. See you next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye.